what I have here is a light bulb that's connected to this plug, but if you'll notice right here, these two wires are not touching. I'm going to plug it in, and you'll see that the light bulb does not light up. This is called an open circuit. Electricity is a flow of electrons through wires. Okay, that's one type of electricity. And it must complete a circuit, and that means they all have to go in a circle, these electrons. And let me just show you, if I take this and touch it like this, make sure that the wires touch. There we go. And I plug it in, and we have light, because now we have a complete circuit. This is very dangerous because I'm using 120 volt AC current from household. In my notes, I show a better way, or you can Google it, using a 9 volt battery. Not quite as impressive. So now, what I have here is some water. Does the water conduct electricity? If we put something between these two wires that conducts electricity, the light bulb will light up. The more electricity it conducts, the brighter the light will be. So, does water conduct electricity? Does pure water conduct electricity? Alright, I have now plugged it in. I have taken some of this pure water and put it in this canister right, in this beaker right here, and we shove it in there, and we have no electricity. So pure water does not conduct electricity. But let's take something else, a very common material, table salt, better known as sodium chloride. Let's just put a little bit in there. And give it a stir. And let's test to see if it lights up. Look at that, the light bulb lights up very, very brightly. All right. We're going to rinse this so we didn't contaminate it. So we can see that what we call sodium chloride would be called a strong electrolyte because a solution of it, when it dissolved, conducted electricity very strongly. Well, now let's take a look at another common material. We'll look at sugar. Here another, have another piece of water to show you it's not conducting. And let's put some sugar in here. Sugar is actually sucrose, made up of carbon, hydrogens, and oxygens. And we'll give it a stir. And we get nothing. Sucrose is a non-electrolyte. It doesn't conduct, a solution of sucrose does not conduct electricity. So now let's try another common material. We're going to look at calcium carbonate. Let me get another glass here, show you it's not conducting electricity. Calcium carbonate is very common. It is the primary ingredient of limestone, and also if you have antacids, most antacids contain calcium carbonate. So we'll put some calcium carbonate in there. This would be like Tums or Rolaids. And we'll give it a stir. And I hope you can see that the light bulb is very, very dimly lit up, very dimly. That's because calcium carbonate is an electrolyte, but it's what we call a weak electrolyte. Let's try one more thing. Let's do a little rinse here. Let's try one more. I'm going to come over here out of your viewpoint and get some tap water. This is Bella Vista tap water from the Bella Vista Water Company. And we'll see what happens there. And again, oh, look at that. It must have some electrolytes in it also. So tap water is not pure water. It has electrolytes in it. Electrolytes are, in the chemical world, are known as ions. In the water quality world, they're often called minerals, and also in the nutrition world. But they're all the same. Electrolytes, ions, and minerals refer to the ionic compounds. And if they dissolve in water to form ions, you have what we call electrolytes. And they range from very strong to weak to non. Not at all. Non-electrolytes don't form ions when they dissolve in water.